With the monsoon season a full 2 months away, the most extreme part of our fire season is directly ahead.
One part of New Mexico may have the highest fire danger in the state, and the tens of thousands of people who live there just had a real big scare. First Alert meteorologist Eric Green is on the fire alert.
It was a story I heard Marissa read on Monday morning that sounded unusual at first.
On the fire alert this morning, the winds were no help to crews fighting a blaze in the Sandias over the weekend. Bernalillo County officials say the fire near Dock Long picnic area was small, only about 20 to 30 feet. It was quickly contained.
Yes, that tiny wildfire the size of a typical Albuquerque backyard was a small realization of a giant fear that everyone has to share as part of the trade-off for living in a beautiful and rural mountain community.
People that live and work back here in the East Mountains are really breathing a big sigh of relief after Saturday's fire was put out before it had a chance to grow. It's just a matter of time before a big fire does get started back here in the East Mountains, because fuels for fires are about 10 times as dense as they should be.
The Sandias have not seen fire over 100 years. Because of that, we have an incredible buildup of fuels in the forest.
Viewed from a distance in Sky 7, you can really see all the lumber available to burn, and some big dead patches of trees from bark beetles are also visible in various states of decay that will only add to the potential flames.
We were just lucky. The area around here, we are lined up for a large fire. And we know it, all the agencies know it, the people who live in this community know it.
It's estimated that there are about 35,000 homes and 75,000 people living on the east side of the Sandias and Manzanos. I'm First Alert meteorologist Eric Green, KOAT Action 7 News.
All of New Mexico's mountain residents are urged to create a defensible space of at least 50 feet around the perimeter of their home. Today, a special meeting is planned for the East Mountain residents to learn how to properly react if they see smoke or fire. The U.S. Forest Service wants to make sure people know calling 911 is not always the best thing to do, because usually too many people end up calling at once, which can clog the system. Fire officials want people living in the mountains to come to the meeting to learn about their options. Meeting is at 6 at the Sandia Ranger Station in Tijeras, just south of the interstate on Highway 337.
Crews are trying to get a handle on a large wildfire in Southern California before strong winds return. More than 1,000 homes were threatened. The danger continues as blistering 90-degree heat and 100-mile-an-hour gusts create treacherous conditions. 700 troops are battling the fire from the ground because the winds grounded the helicopters.
We're seeing a very, what we call a dirty burn. Fire's kind of moving around in a lot of weird places.
The fire may be 10% contained, but the gusts are still incredibly strong, adding to fears it could flare the flames once again.